Hello, my name is Jonathan Turner, and I'm a Principal Product Marketing Manager at Waters Corporation. And today, I'm going to talk about HILIC and where this chromatographic technique can fit into your laboratory. HILIC, or hydrophilic interaction chromatography, is a complementary technique to reversed phase chromatography, which most separation scientists are quite familiar with. With HILIC, a polar stationary phase is used with an organic-rich, low-water content mobile phase. The HILIC stationary phase and the strong elution solvents are both polar, and opposite to what's used for reverse phase separations. And it is why HILIC is sometimes referred to as reverse phase chromatography. The differences in the HILIC stationary phase and the mobile phase leads to a difference in retention and selectivity that is based on analyte hydrophobicity and hydrophilicity, as seen in the chromatography here, where the elution order is reversed for the hydrophilic and hydrophobic analytes. The benefits of HILIC over reverse phase chromatography is that the retention increases with analyte polarity. Polar compounds that elute in the void in reverse phase chromatography are well retained when using HILIC. The chart shown here highlights where HILIC fits in when compared to reverse phase and normal phase chromatography. HILIC works best when there is a need to increase the retention of hydrophilic or ionizable compounds. Also, since HILIC mobile phases often contain greater than 80% organic solvent, HILIC is very beneficial when improved electrospray ionization mass spec response is required for these polar analytes. Here are just a few HILIC separation examples. HILIC chromatography is successfully used in laboratories today for the retention and separation of things like sugars or other oligosaccharides, amino acids, and various polar metabolites. If you're looking to use HILIC in your laboratory, you'll find that there are many HILIC column chemistries to choose from, as the chemistry of a HILIC column plays a critical role in analyte retention and selectivity. Shown here are HILIC stationary phases separated into two groups. The first group has a surface that's unmodified bare silica or hybrid particles. These chemistries have good retention for polar basic compounds because the surface silanols can be deprotonated and act as cation and exchangers. The second group, polar chemically bonded stationary phases, can have either a neutral polar surface, a charged surface, or a zwitterionic surface. And these phases often provide increases in retention and a different selectivity. Examples of some bonded HILIC chemistries are amino phases, amide phases, diol phases, and sulfobutane. With all the work over the years that's been done to improve and expand HILIC, there are still unmet needs that are being explored. Specific needs are for faster separations, additional selectivities, lower mass spec bleed, and chemical stability, specifically when using alkaline, high pH mobile phases. I'd like to thank you for taking the time to listen to this overview on HILIC, its benefits, and where this chromatographic technique can fit into your laboratory. Additional information in upcoming videos will address HILIC retention mechanisms and provide insights on HILIC methods development. If you'd like to be the first to know about Waters' exciting new HILIC column chemistry coming this October, please go to the link below and sign up.